It's over here with Jerry, one of the ring announcers and translators also. How are you feeling?
Christian, I'm feeling good. Good to be here with you.
You know, what can we say? You know, this is, you know, one of the great shows that Eddie Hearn, you know, is, you know, bringing boxing over here in Philly. We see in other, you know, parts of the United States that he's, you know, promoting fights, and I think, you know, it's great for the sport. Eventually, right now, we're gonna have, you know, Macias Zulecki against Gabriel Rosado, you know, who's basically gonna, we're gonna see who's winning, or who's gonna be the winner and challenge Demetrius Andrade. And, but of course, you know, before all of that, there's a name in Mexico, an icon, a superstar, that right now is the name that everyone wants to fight. What do you think of that?
Canelo has to be, there's only one. It has to be Canelo. It has to be, it's the only thing, you know?
Yep.
Obviously, Canelo is the money guy. Canelo is the money man, 365 million. Obviously, the zone knows what he has, what he brings to the table. And obviously, everybody wants to beat him. Guys coming from below, lower divisions, guys from above. Making the chance or the possibility of maybe cutting some weight and making a bout with him. Obviously, it's where the big money is. That's the big name at the moment, internationally.
Yes. You just mentioned, you know, international, they want Canelo, even we've seen the different weight class that they wanted, you know, challenge Canelo, Dimitri, you know, Bivol is one of them. And what do you think of, you know, if I would say, you know, correctly, or you can correct me, is this the era of Canelo in order that, you know, all these boxers, middleweights, and there are also, we have Jerry Hurd. Jerry Hurd also wants to go in 160, and maybe if the future happens, you know, he would like
but
to challenge Canelo.
But it's Canelo time. It's like before it was Mayweather time, this is Canelo time, you know, and that's it. And, you know, unfortunately, one of the things that he has is that his personality, you know, he's a very reserved individual. You know, he doesn't have this big flashy persona, you know, obviously. So that makes a difference in terms of marketing. But it's his time. It's right now. It's Canelo. It's Canelo time.
Canelo Alvarez. I think
he's the target. He's everyone's target.
I think if I'm not mistaken, he's the most well-known, you know, paid athlete in history. If we compare other, you know, boxing, you know, I mean, other events like, you know, football, baseball.
Exactly. Baseball doesn't matter. It is the number one athlete. $165 million a year.
Hey.
A year, I'm sorry. For the contract.
It's for the contract,
ridiculous.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous money. And no matter what Mayweather might want to say in terms of how the contract is split and how he was getting more, like maybe Showtime or so on, there's no doubt. Canelo is the cash cow.
The cash cow.
Pacquiao was at one moment the cash cow for Top Rank. Canelo is the cash cow.
Now we've seen Canelo. What do you think now that, you know, recently Triple G just, you know, joined it, you know, the song, which is, you know, it's great for, you know, all these middleweights that, mm-hmm. you know, eventually they're gonna, you know, perform, you know, by the time that it is the correct, you know, time.
It's absolutely.
Do you think that Canelo can bring one fight in Mexico City in order that, you know, let's understand.
I would hope that we would have a fight, maybe a rematch you're talking about. Triple G Canelo in Mexico City. That would be amazing. Estadio Azteca with 100,000+.
Wow.
Oh.
That would
be
an
earthquake.
That would be an earthquake,
be
you
an
know.
Earthquake.
And I think, you know, the fight fans deserve that from Mexico City. One of the fights, either way, you know, it could be
and,
Triple
and to,
G.
And to put all doubts aside. And okay, so who's the winner overall, finally? You know, obviously, there's a difference in age, and there's a possibility that Triple G may be slowing, obviously. So, but you have to see, and the only way to see is in the ring. That's where the proof is.
Definitely, I agree with you. You know, more upcoming events that will be this year. Let's, you know, say, give it a 2 thumbs up, you know, to Eddie Hearn, your Matchroom Boxing, the Zone, and everyone
Absolutely.
That is part of, you know, this. You know, movement right
that's
now.
That's the new player. That's the new player in boxing, no doubt. On the internet, on TV, in live events, that's the player, period, internationally. And not only what they do with boxing, but what they do with soccer, with what they do with many other sports. And you look at their list in terms of programming, what they have, it's amazing.
Definitely, pay-per-view, I would say, is done. The new era, the sun.
Absolutely.
Mr. Jerry, would you like to bring a message to all the fight fans and invite, you know, to see all these great events that are upcoming, you know, 2019?
Un abrazo muy fuerte. Viene lo mejor por delante, sin duda, en este año de 2019. All the best is yet to come in this 2019. There's obviously lots of new things happening. We sometimes are reluctant to make change, but change is sometimes very good, and you have to accept it and you have to embrace it. And I think this is the year for amazing things in terms of boxing and the zone special.
I agree with you, you know. I wish you always the best, you know.
Thank you so much.
And we're gonna stay tuned and keep your eye, you know, in all these things that are gonna happen tonight over here at the arena.
Gracias, un abrazo.